Hello everyone, welcome to Indian Judicial Service. Today we are covering question number 261 to 270. This is the part 12 of top 300 MCQ of Indian Evidence Act. Now starting up. Question number 261. Which section of Indian Evidence Act was amended by Criminal Law Amendment Act 2005? Section 154, Section 118, Section 32 of Evidence Act, Section 90A of Evidence Act. So here answer is option A, Section 154 of Evidence Act. The amendment in 154, subsection 1, in 2005. So question number 262. What essential change was made in certain section 154 of Evidence Act 1872 by Criminal Law Amendment Act 2005. Two statements sought to be contradicted in addition should be drawn to previous statement. The party is entitled to rely on any part of evidence of the witness to whom he has called to put any question, to him, and which might be put in cross examination by the adverse party. In cross examination, the adverse party asks leading question. So in this section, section 154, the provide the provision of put any question by a party to his own called witness whom he called. Okay, so here this is the answer of this question, option B. What essential change was made in section 154 of Evidence Act 1872 in Criminal Amendment Act 2005? So the party is entitled to rely on any part of evidence the witness to whom he has called to put any question, including leading question, which is generally asked in cross examination. Now question number 263. A confession to be inadmissible under section 25 of Evidence Act must relate to the same crime for which the offender is charged, may relate to a same crime of which offender is charged, must relate to another crime, none of the above. So in this answer is here option B, may relate to the same crime for which offender is charged. Question number 264. The provision hostile witness provided under section, so it is provided in 154 Indian Evidence Act. So option section 155, section 133, section 154, section 145. So I previously mentioned here option C, section 154. The section 154 provided that the provision of hostile witness. In which of the following case the Supreme Court hold that test identification parade is only an aid to investigation? The practice is not borne out of produce. Option A, Siddharth Nath Vasist at the rate Manu Sharma versus State of NCT of Delhi, AIR 2010. So this is the correct answer here, Siddharth Vasist Manu Sharma and Manu Sharma, Siddharth Vasist and Manu Sharma versus NCT of Delhi. So there is even another question, important question. In which section the test identification parade is mentioned? Please provide the answer in comment box. Okay. Question number 266. The circumstantial evidence is considered weaker evidence as compared to direct evidence because it has a two error of fallibility of a fact from which the inference, which inference is drawn being proved. And option point two is here, second error here, of the inference to be drawn from the fact proved. So according to the question, the circumstance of evidence, consider a weaker evidence. So in which circumstance shows that the circumstantial evidence is weaker, and what is the main element which shows that the circumstantial is weaker? So these two elements are shows the circumstantial evidence is weaker. First is the fact from which inference is drawn being proved, and second one, the inference to be drawn from the fact proved. So option A is correct here. Question number 266. In the law of evidence, fact means and include anything perceived by sense. This is very important here, perceived by sense. The state of things capable of being perceived by senses. Mental condition, third is important point, mental condition of which a person is conscious. So please remember these three terms: anything perceived by sense, the state of things, and mental condition. So option D is correct here, all of the above. These three terms shows the meaning of fact. Question number 268. By dying declaration is relevant evidence under section 32 of Evidence Act, not withstanding it being hearsay evidence, because the statement by a person as to a cause of his death is treated in law as Solomon's statement. If the person is died and anything said by the person as to cause of death is relevant, since the death cannot be brought before the court. This is very important here. To testimony, necessity make it inevitable to admit said statement. So if the person is died and during that his death condition he said the some statement, and these statement is related to his cause of death, such type of statement is dying declaration DD, and the DD is the exception of hearsay evidence, because of the death person is cannot be present before the court for testimony. That's why option D is correct in this question. The dying declaration is relevant evidence under section 32 of Evidence Act, not withstanding in being hearsay evidence, because of this reason. Okay, question number 269. The Evidence Act does not apply to proceeding before arbitrator. Yes, it is correct. It does not apply. Yes, it is not applied arbitrator. The affidavit submitted by the deponent of his own. Yes, it is also not applied. The statement made by child. Yes, Evidence Act is apply the own statement of child. Statement of any person who has capable to understand the question and giving the relevant answer. So there is no matter of child, an extreme old person, or sound mind or unsound mind, nothing. The person who is capable to understand the question and giving the relevant answer of that question. The statement of a person whose past is criminal, yes, it is also given. So these two terms, the evidence does not apply to 1 and 2. So option C is correct here. Question number 270. The question is whether the murder of X was committed by Y. The fact that Y produced an admission slip of hospital indicating the dislocation of hip bone during the period of alleged murder, which one among the following is the correct provision of the Indian Evidence Act, under which is the relevant? Under section 6, under section 9, under section 10, under section 11. So in this question, the answer is under section 11. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please click on like button and don't forget to share our videos and to your friend and relatives, and please subscribe our channel. Thank you.